David Bay here from MuscularDevelopment.com. I'm down here in South Florida for the 2013 NPC National Championships, hanging out here with heavyweight competitor Brad Rowe and his fiance, Stephanie Rodriguez, a fitness competitor, figure competitor. Her eyes got real big. She's like, I'm not fitness. No routine. Brad, we're going to start with you. You've had a really solid run over the last few years at a national level, a lot of top five placings, slipped out maybe once or twice, but for the most part, you've been a front runner in almost every national show that you've done. Now at the North Americans, one of the things that we were talking about on the MuscularDevelopment.com forums is they had switched all the rules regarding who gets a pro card if somebody in the Masters division wins their pro card Masters. I know it was a little bit of a disappointment for you because myself and everybody else in the audience kind of thought Brad Rowe's going to walk away with the pro card. Again, they switched it because of the stuff that happened with Dan Decker the previous year. Talk to us a little bit about your competition preparation between the North Americans and this show. Now from August to November, not a lot of time to make significant changes as far as your size or anything like that is, but more than enough time as far as conditioning and stuff like that. Talk to us a little bit about what you've been doing the past couple months.
Yeah, I mean, right after North Americans, obviously it was a little frustrating, but I mean, I walk away with my head held high because it was the best look that I've ever brought. I never thought I'd bring conditioning like that and this type of hardness. So beyond happy with how I looked, for 20 minutes backstage, everybody was congratulating me, telling me I was pro and this and that. And then I get the letdown and I was just like, oh, God damn it. So, and before North Americans, I was fully set on walking away for the year and just shutting it down. I told her, I was like, win or lose, I'm done for the year. I just started a small business. We just got engaged.
Congratulations.
We need to shut it down and have a life. And then when you're that close and it's just like, yeah. Okay, I'm the type of person that's just like, all right. So she's like, you're doing the show. Let's go. I'll support you. Let's get through this. So, we took a period of time and just relaxed, recovery, training kind of went down a little bit. Was eating a ton of food, no cardio, just kind of let my body readjust because I did USA's and North Americans. I've been dieting for a while. And really, the whole idea was just try to bring in a little tighter package, make a little more changes into my chest and my back, some thickness. And I think that we made a little bit of changes that we need to. So hopefully, I'll look about 10% bigger on stage, maybe about 10% harder. And that was kind of the goal. So we knew that we couldn't bring anything crazy. It was just try to beat your best. And then it's up to the judges at that point.
Yeah, and at prejudging at North Americans, really the only area I saw you even slip behind Julius Page, who earned his pro card 1 year weight class, was just in your back shots. I mean, from your front and your side shots, I think everybody was in agreement that, I don't want to say that you were ahead of him, but you guys were neck and neck. He was one of those guys with a tiny waist and broad shoulders. Right. But, I think if you're able to bring up your back, you should.
And a lot of it comes down to posing, too, and presentation. And they had like nine guys up on the first call out. And, I'm trying to battle out arm positioning, and so I'm trying to get my arms back, and I just crunched myself up too small, which accentuates my narrowness in my back, so I didn't help myself out at all.
Yeah, when you're up there and there's a bunch of guys, people might not realize that when they put that big of a call out, you don't have that much room to spread out. When you're doing a rear double bicep, you got to flip those lats out. It's tough if you're tough in and pinched,
ahead of someone, you're gonna look small out there. So everybody's trying to fight to get back and get closer to the judges. So hopefully, they give us a little room and they try to do the best they can so everybody can have room to actually hit the poses properly.
Yeah, for those of you guys who aren't familiar, what we just had referred to, we're just going to give them a quick overview. I know we had talked about it at the North Americans. In the past, what they had done is if somebody won their pro card in the Masters division, they pulled them from the open. Well, what happened in 2012 was Dan Decker won the super heavyweights in the Masters. Everybody assumed, they didn't release the scorecards, I don't believe, but I think everybody assumed that Dan won the super heavyweights in the open division too, and people assumed that Dan was going to win the overall in the open. Now, Dan won his pro card as a master, so they pulled him out. It's my understanding that Dan was a little bit upset that he was given his pro card in the Masters, wasn't allowed to go for the open overall. So what they did this year is they flip-flopped it. Instead of pulling somebody out of the open for the second pro card, they gave the pro card that would have gone to the second place in the open to the guy who got second place in the Masters overall. So instead of Brad getting a pro card, which I think everybody assumed until last minute, Ebony Wilson got a pro card. That's how that went down.
Is what it is.
We hope you get one this weekend.
If it doesn't happen, then it's just back to the drawing board, and you can't get too upset. It's not like basketball or football where you put up points. It's a subjective sport, and You know, you don't do it for the placings and the winnings. You can ask her. I truly love the challenge. I love being miserable. I'm just a miserable prick all the time. It just fits my personality. You know, I tell her she's doing the show too, and you know, she's always so bright and bubbly and happy. And so when she's in a bad mood, you can tell. And I'm like, that's the best thing about being, you know, a miserable prick all the time is when I'm in a bad mood, you don't know if it's just Wednesday or if I'm really upset. I'm like, so
if nothing else, you're consistent.
Exactly.
All right. Now, Stephanie, you've competed nationally already. You did the USA's earlier on this year, got third place in figure. And what was your first show?
It was the weekend right before that, the LA.
So your first show, jumped into the LA, you won that, got third place at the USA's a week after you started competing, which isn't too bad. Talk to us a little bit about what you've done between, you know, the USA's and nationals. Now, I know one of the issues for figure competitors and bikini competitors is if you have a look on stage that the judges really like, you know, you have to try to repeat that, you know, a couple months later. But for figure competitors, you don't want to be too lean, you don't want to be too big, too soft. So it's almost like, you know, here we are, you know, a handful of months later, but you have to almost repeat exactly what you did there. You know, how do you go about trying to do that?
Well, I kind of looked at the lineup, the first call out of girls, and I compared myself to the first and second place winner that got their pro cards. Congratulations. Their shoulders were significantly bigger than mine. I don't know if it was the way I was posing, because granted it was my second show, so I was nervous as hell, and I don't think I was posing properly. But my shoulders and then my glute and hamstring tie-in. So I went back to Gold's, and Charles saw the lineup as well. And so Charles, we basically hit shoulders twice a week.
Charles.
Glass.
Oh, so you're training with Charles Glass.
Yeah, we both train with Charles.
At 7 a.m.
Yeah. So we hit shoulders twice a week. We hit legs twice a week. And then every other day I have auxiliary work for my glute and hamstring tie-in. So I have step-ups and sumo squats and lunges and all sorts of things just to hit that area specifically. Also, we changed up my cardio. Sprints only.
Sprints only, all real high intensity?
High intensity. My legs are a little bit bigger than my upper body, and so we were trying to bring my legs down. So it was all inclined sprints. Oh. And so we're talking, I mean, 6-7 miles in the morning, go back and do 5 miles at night. So I'm putting some miles on these babies.
She's talking about all the stuff Charles Glass has her doing. I'm sitting here taking mental I'm taking mental notes over here. All right. Well, now you guys, you know, everybody knows when you're dieting for a show, if you have a significant other that you live, I know it's hot as hell in here. I don't know if it's just the lights or everywhere. It's hot. But you know, it can be difficult dieting just when you have a boyfriend or girlfriend, you know, it poses a lot of challenges. Now you guys live together. Is that correct? Brad, talk to us a little bit about two people in the same household dieting. How does that work? Are you guys at each other's throats? Are you fighting over mirror time, stuff like that?
You know, it's, We butt heads, you know, because you're tired and you know you're miserable half the time. But our schedules are so opposite. You know, I'm out of the house at almost 3:30 in the morning every day for my business. I either go in the kitchen and cook, or I'm on the road doing deliveries. Then I go do my cardio. When I'm leaving the gym, she's getting to the gym to train. And then, you know, I go back in the middle of the day, I train clients, I train myself. And then when I get home, she's leaving to go do her second session of cardio.
So, we're just doing this all
so literally, she's coming to bed. And, you know, for last year, for a couple of preps, you know, we slept in different bedrooms because I like it freezing cold. And, you know, she can't sleep that well. I want a fan and an air conditioner on. I need that.
I'm the same way. Yeah.
So we were sleeping in different rooms because I'm tossing and turning, sweating like crazy, farting up a storm. You know,
yeah, it's not pleasant. We're both it's so not pleasant. Everyone's so like, you're good. So lucky. No.
So
no, it's horrible.
So
I look like
any
an
rest,
Eskimo.
You know, for either one of us, because when you're dieting, it's, you know, you're antsy as it is. So we've been sleeping in different bedrooms, you know, for majority of our relationship, really. I mean, we got engaged the week before the LA. You know, I knew the first year we were together, I did three shows and she was with me the entire time and never bitched and moaned and cooked my meals and help however she could. And, you know, and I knew that, wow, this is a keeper right here.
I should have gone out. Wow.
Run.
And then I convinced her into competing this year. Finally, you know, it was always something that she wanted to do. When I first met her, we met at Gold's Gym and, you know, she comes up and starts chatting to me and I'm like, oh, what's your goal? She's like, well, I've never competed before, but I will be on the Olympia stage one day. And that just hit me, you know. Yeah. And neither of us would ever want to date anybody.
You were like, I should ask this girl out.
But you know, neither of us had ever dated anybody from the gym. We don't, you know, that's our home. You know, you don't shit where you eat. And we had seen each other for over a year, just like kind of staring at each other and checking each other out. I thought she had a boyfriend because she was training with some guy. And I was just me, my miserable self. I'm head down, you know, don't talk to anybody. So she finally introduced herself. And our first couple dates, we're doing cardio. And we actually
cardio dates.
It's Steramil. It's pretty pathetic. Yeah,
yeah, we got engaged at Gold's. I set up a workout video the week before her show, and the ring wasn't in yet, so I got a little fake silver barbell clip made to propose with, so she can wear that. And then the ring came right before USA. So, you know, it's we complement each other so well. You know, we butt heads, but we're both very strong people, so we don't take things personal. You know, I can yell and call her this and that, and
you gotta have a real quick rebound rate.
And we're just like, okay, 2 seconds later, I love you. You know, that's good. So, you know, we do really well together, but you know, it's easy because you don't have to worry about this person being like, oh, I want to go to the movies, right. But you can't.
As far as dieting goes, it's simple. It's really easy. I mean, he runs a meal prepping service. We don't have, you know, crap food in the house. If you want to have a cheat meal, you literally have to leave the house, like get a hotel room so that there's no evidence anywhere. So it's just way too much work. It's so much easier when your other we half is dieting.
It's hard having food in the house. I know for as motivated as competitors are, it's like when it's there, it's like you'll be sitting in bed at like 2 a.m. being like, if I ate 3 Oreos, I could probably do an extra 20 minutes of cardio.
PB2 our biggest weaknesses. And we're good friends with with the owners of Quest, and she's always sending us cases. So I'm like, Aceto is like, hate you because of how many Quest bars I eat. So she sent him a huge case, a jokingly gift, and he's like, I was wondering who the fuck sent me this case of Quest bars. I'm like, so thank you very much, Shannon. So I mean, you know, that's my idea of a cheat meal now. I've been dieting for so long, is like a Quest bar and some PB2 is
That's not a cheat meal, man. I'll tell you what a cheat meal is.
We used to be the most epic cheaters before we're dieting. We would split off in different directions, spend about $150, and it would take us about an hour to collect all the different things from all the different stores.
That's what buffets are for.
We created a buffet.
Right, we create our own buffet.
Your own buffet.
We like, you know, Chinese food, pizza, subs from certain places. You know, we have all these little things that we like, because you only get to eat it once every 2 weeks or something. Right. I want what I want, and I'm going to spend, that's the only thing I indulge in money on. I don't buy clothes, I don't buy shit. I spend money on food.
On $150 buffets. So, all right, guys, we're gonna wrap this thing up. I'm sweating. I'm gonna try to see if I can't get a fan over here or something. Well, guys, best of luck to you both this weekend. And you know, moving forward, competition aside, I think if the both of you had made it through contest prep without killing each other, you'll probably be good down the road. So, all right, guys, this is David Bay with Brad Rowe and Stephanie Rodriguez for MuscularDevelopment.com at the 2013 NPC National Championship.